Hello friends, in the sixth lecture of the analysis of a simple truss, we'll solve examples. So in this lecture, we'll solve example number one, that is, find the force in all the members of the truss shown below by the method of joints. So here we are using method of joints, and later on we'll be doing graphical method. But at first stage, this method is very important, and it will also require a huge concentration. So don't miss any of the part of this lecture. This is the truss shown in the question. Each and every details are mentioned in the truss, and rest of the details we need to find. That is, here at apex 40 kN of load is given, two support reactions are given, which we need to find because they are not mentioned. The size of this greatest member, that means it may be hypotenuse as this is 90 degree, is given 3.6 meter. But the length of this AC and AB members are not given in this truss. So we'll calculate that also. And the main thing which we need to find is forces in all the members. So our main aim is to find the member forces, or we can say internal stresses. Here this angle is given 30 degree, this given 60 degree. So as we know that sum of angles of a triangle is 180 degree. So the remaining one is 90 degree. 60 plus 30 becomes 90, and this one will be 90. 90 plus 90, 180 degree. So now let us start with the solution, where our step one is assuming truss to be perfect and find all the dimensions of the member. So here I am drawing this truss again, showing these two reactions as reaction at point B vertical, reaction at point C vertical, which we need to calculate, and this value of X and this value of member AB also we need to calculate. So from triangle ABC, here I have put this triangle oriented like this, such that this A is 90 degree, this one, B and C. So this is the same triangle, but shown to explain you very easily. This at point angle B is 60 degree, angle C is 30 degree, and this becomes 90. So let us try and calculate from triangle ABC, that is ABC, cos 60 is equal to AB upon BC, because adjacent side upon hypotenuse. Cos 60 is equal to AB upon BC. So this becomes the adjacent side. Sorry. Cos 60 is equal to AB upon BC. So this becomes the adjacent side, and this becomes the hypotenuse. So cos 60 is equal to BA upon BC. Or we can say AB upon BC. One and the same thing. Adjacent side upon hypotenuse. Now from this, let us make AB as the subject. Why? Because we need to find the dimension of the AB. So I'm making AB as the subject and BC cos 60. Now value of BC is directly given over here, that is 3.6 meter. So I'm writing over here 3.6 into cos 60, that is 0.5. Our answer is 1.8 meter. So I am mentioning here in the truss 1.8 meter, that is the length of member AB. Now for finding length of member BD, I am taking triangle ABD, triangle ABD, so this triangle, or we can concentrate here directly, this ABD. So cos 60 is equal to adjacent side upon hypotenuse. Again, it will be adjacent side, suppose we say X, or we can say BD upon AB. BD upon AB, adjacent side upon hypotenuse. So BD, if we make it subject, AB cos 60, value of AB we found just recently, that is 1.8 AB. And value of cos 60 is 0.5. So the answer is 0.9 meter. that is the length of member BD. So I'm mentioning here BD, that is 0.9 meter. So now we got all the dimensions of this truss. That is 3.6 meter BC, BD that is 0.9 meter, AB that is 1.8 meter. This one is not required. If it would be required, then we'll find it. Then after, next step will be finding the support reactions. See, we need to remember the sequence in which we are writing the steps. Support reactions. So we are finding support reaction RBV and RCV. How did this came? So for that, taking moment at B is equal to zero. Here, taking moment at this point is equal to zero. I can make it clockwise moment is equal to anti-clockwise moment. So for showing clockwise moment from this point, 40 into distance is 0.9. So this 40 will be acting on the line of action here. So 40 into 0.9 and it will be going clockwise around point B. So it will be positive, or we can write it in the clockwise side, 40 into 0.9. 40 into 0.9 is equal to, this one becomes anti-clockwise side. Taking point B as reference, RCV. So distance between RCV and B is 3.6. So RCV into 3.6 and it is going anti-clockwise. So we have written here RCV into 3.6 on anti-clockwise side moment. So here we can make RCV as the subject and find the value of RCV. So it is 10 kilonewton. So first thing is, I'm mentioning here 10 kilonewton and we know how this did came. After that, for finding RBV, I'm writing, now for RBV, taking sigma V is equal to zero, that vertical reactions, summation of the vertical reactions are zero, or we can say downward reactions is equal to upward reactions. Let us try and understand. This 40 kilonewton is going downwards while this 10 kilonewton is going upwards. So 40 is equal to 10 plus RBV. This both are going upwards and this one is going downwards. So same thing is written over here. 40 is equal to RBV plus 10. So RBV becomes 30 kilonewtons. So we have found the support reaction. I'm mentioning over here 30 kilonewton. So our step 2 becomes complete. Now in step 3, as this is my method, this step 3 is developed by me and it is very easy to understand. So what is it? Assuming the member's forces. Here we are assuming some of the member forces. What we are assuming is direction, or we can say nature. As per our previous lecture, we understood that if the force is tensile, that is, here it is, member is pulling, the force is pulling the member, the internal forces of this member will try to oppose it, that is, it will face towards each other. Now if it is directing towards each other, then it will be tensile force. And opposite of that, if the member is getting compressed by the two forces, this member forces will try to oppose and direct opposite to each other. So if it is opposing each other, it will be compressive force. Right now we are concentrating on these two portions, not on the force. External force is applied. So I am assuming direction of the forces, or we can say internal forces, in such a way. Here member AC, I am directing it outwards. So we can say I am assuming it to be in compression. I am also assuming member AB to be in the compression, because I am assuming it, the arrows pointing outwards. So it is in compression. Right now I am just assuming all this. Later on we can correct it if we are wrong. Here in member BC, the arrows are facing towards each other. So it is tension. We can say tensile force. Later on we can compare and change the directions and nature of the forces if required. So the next step will be, selecting the joint. So from this truss, we have to select the joint as per the steps we understood in the previous lecture, where at first I am selecting this joint B. So I am drawing this joint B over here and detailing it. Here it is the same thing as mentioned over here. I am picking up this and putting it over here. This becomes C side and this becomes A side. The reaction what we found was, reaction at point B vertical was 30 kN. And these are the first arrows what we assumed it just in the previous step. That is this arrow and this arrow. The first arrow approaching from the point B. So if this is directing outwards, this is directing inwards. This is directing outwards, this is directing inwards. So this is the same copy. Then comes components of this FBA, that is force in member BA. I am making component parts in sine and cos. That is, if this is 60, this also becomes 60. Alternate angles, this is forming a Z. Now the side facing the angle will be cos FBA cos 60, and side opposite to the angle will become FBA sin 60. So this is cos, this is sin. This is how I meant the component. So now we'll try solving, or we can say we'll try finding out these forces FBA and FBC, and we'll check whether the assumed direction of the forces are correct or we have to change the direction. So for joint B, first of all we are taking sigma V is equal to 0, that is summation of the vertical forces to be 0. This is one vertical force going downwards, FBA sin 60, and this is the another vertical force facing upwards, that is 30. FBA sin 60 is equal to 30. So this is the equation what we got from sigma V is equal to 0. And making FBA subject, and we got force in member BA to be 34.64 kN. So first of all we got the value, that is 34.64. Now what we need to mark is whether the value is positive or negative. Here it is positive, so it simply means that FBA, this direction what we assumed, is perfectly all right, it is correct. So we don't have to change the direction of this force FBA or FAB, what that was directing from the opposite side. So it is correct. Let us read the note. As the value is positive, the assumed direction of the member forces are correct for member AB. So if it was negative, then we had to turn this arrow towards each other. But right now it is facing away from the each other, and this is right. So our assumption was correct, and we also got values, that is 34.64 kN. Then after, for finding FBC, we need to calculate horizontal component. Equation is summation of the horizontal component to be 0. This FBC is horizontal, and FBA cos 60 is also horizontal. Both are facing opposite side. So we can write FBC is equal to FBA cos 60, and there are no any other horizontal component. So I am writing FBC is equal to FBA cos 60. So finding the values, FBA we can put up from here what we found recently, 34.64, cos 60 is 0.5. So we got the value of FBC here, this one. Again, this is positive, so our assumed direction of this arrow is correct. We can write down, as the value is positive, the assumed direction of the member forces are correct, that is for member BC. And we can write down here, that is 17.32 kilonewton. So now, after finding this all the member forces for these two member, we'll continue with step number 5, that is selecting another joint. If required, if we have got all the member forces, then our numerical, or we can say our question will be terminated. But right now, here joint C is remaining, this one. So I am picking up this point C, joint C, and putting it over here. So it is the same thing, RCV 10, 10 kilonewton, 30 degree, it is 30 degree acute angle. This arrow facing outwards, here FCA, FC to A, then here FCB, FCB, I have shown it over here. These are our assumed direction of the forces. And previously what we found was 17.32 to be FCB to be 17.32, as we found it over here. FBC, or we can say FCB, one and the same thing, 17.32. So I have written over here 17.32. Now what we need to find is FCA. That is why we are here at joint C. Again, this becomes point A, this becomes point B, making component parts of point A. This becomes our Z. 30, 30 becomes the alternate angle. FCA cos 30. Cos because it is adjacent side, and this becomes the opposite side, so it is sine component. FCA sine 30, this is FCA cos 30. Again, solving vertical component to be 0, summation of vertical component to be 0. Check out all the vertical reactions and forces over here. This is one vertical, this is another. So I am writing it directly, FCA sine 60 is equal to FCA, is equal to 10 kilonewton. Downwards is equal to upwards. FCA sine 30 is equal to 10. Making FCA subject, I can directly get the answer, that is 20 kilonewton. So I am writing over here 20 kilonewton. So again, it is positive, and as the value is positive, the assumed direction of the member forces are correct for member CA. The direction which I had assumed over here was right, or else I would have to change the direction. So we can say all the directions what we have shown over here, 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 here are correct, and we don't have to change it. So this was our ultimate aim, to find the member forces and not the external forces. We found was this member forces and the nature. But now let us show it in the tabular form. That is our last step. Step number 6, tabulating the forces. We have to make a table such that SR number, member, force and nature. So from this figure, SR number 1, member BA. Let us check. This is member BA. It is compression. The assumed direction is correct. The value is, what we found was 34.64. This is the member BA. This is the force what we found. And this is the nature, that is compressive. Now SR number 2, BC. BC. It is tensile. Value what we found was 17.32. So let me mention over here, 17.32 kilonewton. This one also is, unit is kilonewton, because it is the unit of force, we have to write kilonewton. And the nature is tensile. And for SR number 3, that is member CA, the value what we found is 20 kilonewton at last. I'm writing 20 kilonewton. And the nature is compressive. I have written compressive. So this is the tabular form in which I am putting the values. With this I am terminating the question number 1, and in next lecture we will be starting with the question number 2. Till that time, just practice this question in your notebook so that we don't have any problem in the upcoming lectures.